So today I'm out of Arizona. I know. I haven't seen enough of it, definitely. But that's mostly because Chile was breaking down. So what's the plan now? Las Vegas! We're off the highway and now we are going to Forma Boots warehouse, which is somewhere here. Here they are. Maybe they'll hear me. That's a lot of Forma Boots.
Hey, you doing, mate? Good to see you.
So I made it. I made it to Nevada. I was rushing here so I can catch up with Darren.
My position is, a director or manager.
Forma USA.
For Forma USA, yeah.
Right. So you guys do not have shop or display as such. You pretty much have this storage and then you distribute boots.
Yes,
all over, right?
Yes, we're a wholesaler, so we supply a dealer network that we work with nationally.
Right. So how long have you been working for Forma?
Yeah, so I've been with Forma, I think 16 years. So
long time.
A long time, yeah.
Look, we have the great t-shirt swap. I'm wearing Forma t-shirt. Darren, you're rocking on her bike t-shirt. Darren and I, we pretty much had this partnership since 2000, I reckon, mate. 13. After I finished my trip around Australia, I did purchase my first Forma boots, but one of them started leaking after all my riding, and then that's how it started. Darren replaced me with one pair of boots, and then now we mates. We did an organized tour in Himalayas 3 years ago. We go way back now.
Yeah,
we're like buddies. So today I'm getting new boots.
I've been using this particular model for the last 3 years, and look at them. Aren't you impressed in such a great shape?
Yeah, I'm actually really surprised. I can see from the soles the lugs are worn down.
A lot of use. A lot of walking, mate.
But the boots have held up really well.
Great. So many
boots.
Crushes, and look, no leg injuries.
Yeah, I can see some marks and scuffs.
Oh, yeah,
you've definitely tested them out.
My little environment fun boxing. So I'm getting socks as well. The compression socks, so good. Wow, they are long. All right, you ready? Okay, socks first. We're in. Right, okay. Sexy socks are on. Now, unboxing. Look at that, it's so nice and shiny and new. Perfect. Size 44, who would think, right? Oh, wow. So what are we doing today, Darren? Chile's parked, and we just jumped in the car, and we're going to
The Grand Canyon via helicopter.
Helicopter flight. The back of the sign. Come back soon. So people are lining up at the front, eh?
Yeah, it's crazy. It's a very popular sign.
Righto, are you in a frame, mate?
Yes, mate.
Good. So what are we doing now, Darren?
We are flying to the Grand Canyon in a helicopter.
That's right. We are about to catch a flight. And we landed. We didn't die. We're in the heart of Grand Canyon, just like that. Look at this.
Magnificent.
That's a very generous pour, thank you.
And we're having our little break on the edge of the Grand Canyon. Look at this. What an epic place. It was a good idea, mate. Darren, how many times have you done this flight?
10.
10.
This is beautiful.
It is. So worth it. Now, Darren is taking me for a little tour around town at night. I mean, this place is crazy. It's crazy.
Ready for this second round of drinks in here, just bring the same ice cup back
with you,
okay?
No worries.
Cheers, mate.
Such a slippery glass. This is Forma team after hours. This is our business meeting. Where are we, guys?
There we go.
Have you guys far?
It's freezing.
And sleepy.
We're drinking our drinks from the glass, ice glasses and all.
Cheers, mate.
Cheers.
But Jack, what happened to your glass? Oh.
The ice is real.
It's real.
Kinga.
Are you ready to do a little bit of narration?
About what?
About our second day in Vegas after all this craziness in downtown. What are we doing now?
Well, we are going to the drive-in right now.
Right now?
Yep, in the desert.
In the desert.
In Las Vegas.
Still in Las Vegas.
It's going to be cold.
It's not going to be cold. Tickets are $8.50, bargain. And yeah, I've never been to such cinema. It's cool, right?
Yeah, I'm excited.
Just came back from the shop. all of this for $8.50 and we have a free refill. Do you think it's enough popcorn for us? It's vegan.
Okay.
True story. So this is how we're gonna listen. We have to set our radio station. Is that us?
Yeah, but there's no sound yet.
Well, there's no sound because there's no movie, mate. The movie's not playing, we still have a few minutes. So this is how we're gonna watch our movie tonight. We got very healthy staff with us. Good job, mate. Alright, so after the movies, we are where now?
We're at Fremont Street.
Which is?
Old Town Vegas. Original Vegas.
$10 million. It's time to leave Vegas, but I just wanted to show you my view from my room. I must say, it's quite premium and I was very, very comfortable here. Okay, you ready? Have a look. This is when I get up, I see this. Incredible, right?
So, we're leaving Vegas, finally. We have to leave Vegas, otherwise we'll never leave. I had so much fun here, thanks to Darren. It just showed me so many places I just wouldn't know where to go, you know. So now I'm going through old Vegas. You remember that, like, this footage with like this screen above the people? So I'm trying to get into that area so we can see it from both sides. We can't drive through there, but we're just gonna drive across it. So look at that. Everything just looks so pale during the day. Wow. So this is where it is. This is it. Okay, pay attention. Insta360 did a good job. Oh, wow. Look at that. That's so cool. We got an action shot. Yes. Okay, I've decided I'm not going to leave just yet. We're going to go through the strip, through the main street where... all of it is happening, but of course now it's daytime, so everyone is hangover. So this is a restaurant, famous restaurant that spins around, sort of like a, I don't know, Las Vegas Tower. I don't know. In Sydney, we call it City Tower. So this is the official arch, I guess, to the strip. And here on the strip, you just have pretty much hotels, casinos. It's all happening here, day and night. I must say, the city is just, yeah, it's one of the kind. Honestly, I've never experienced anything like that. There's so much stuff you can do here. It's not only gambling. I only gambled like $1. I lost it. But there's just so much else is happening. A lot of good shows, theatres, musicals, you know, clubs, live music. I mean, so much. And you definitely spend a lot of money here. Everything is so expensive, I tell ya. But hey, we live once in a lifetime. We have to come to Vegas, I reckon. Okay, so we have a little Venus here. Here's the expensive bit. This is like where the rich people hang out and stay at the hotels. It looks so different daytime. It's just like a bit more quiet, a bit more civilized. I don't know. You know what I mean. Not so flush and shiny, I guess. Look at that. I mean, it's just insane. So the whole strip is 5 miles. So Darren and I, we never walked the full strip. It would be too far. But I reckon maybe half of it we've done. There's just so much happening here. And here on the right, we have the famous Caesar Palace, I think. That's what we call it. That's like the most expensive one. And here we've got Little Pahi. There you go, Eiffel Tower. We've got it all. And this is New York. See, like a mini tiny New York and Statue of Liberty and all. Okay. I think we're now ready to go. This is pretty much the end of the trip. What my plan is for today? Well, it is late. We're left really late. It's like nearly 5. So my plan is now to get out of here. As soon as possible. And we're going to Death Valley. Apparently it's super, super pretty and beautiful. So I'm just gonna find some free camping spot because I really need to be out in the nature again after this city life. I need to bring some balance in my life and camp with chili in the wild. That'd be so nice. Okay, so that's the plan. We just need to get out of here, which might take us a while. It's peak hour now. It wasn't the smartest idea to leave at like 4-ish. All right. So long, Vegas!